Welcome to my presentation. I am Susanna and I am a PhD student at TU Berlin. I will present our work on using variable segment durations for HTTP adaptive streaming. This is a joint work together with my colleagues Nick, Thomas, Christian, Werner and Alex from TU Munich, TU Ilmenau and NTNU Trondheim. So why should we use segments of variable duration? To motivate this, let us have a look on this raw video sequence. It denotes with the different colors different scenes that we have in this video. Now, when it comes to video compression and encoding, the video encoder places iframes efficiently when a new scene starts, and the rest of the scene is encoded using PNB frames, which only contain the information about the difference compared to the preceding iframe. When content is prepared for adaptive streaming, the video has to be split into small segments. The state-of-the-art mechanism applies segments of equal duration, typically something between 2 and 10 seconds. So what would happen now with our video sequence if we want segments of 5 seconds duration, for example? Each segment has to start with an iframe to make it playable independently. So we have to set an additional iframe each 5 seconds, and then we split the video. This, however, is done in a content agnostic manner, and due to the additional iframes that we need, which are costly, we induce a higher encoding overhead. This can be overcome if we allow a certain variability of our segment duration. This means that some of the segments are longer, others are shorter, and so on. This allows us to split the video at positions where iframes are anyways needed due to the scene cuts. And then additional iframes for the sake of segmentation are only needed to ensure that a certain maximum duration is not exceeded. As a result, we get video segments that are aligned with the video content. And while this approach has potential to reduce video bitrate, it is not clear yet to which extent. Furthermore, the implications on the adaptive bitrate algorithms are so far unknown. For that reason, we performed a comparative study in order to evaluate the variable segment durations. The study is divided up into two major parts. The first one is on video encoding. Here we implemented a Docker-based framework which allows to automatically encode and analyze videos. And this has been used to encode videos with a variety of different settings. In total, our dataset consists of about 2,000 video sequences, which were used to evaluate the encoding efficiency gain that we can have with variable segment durations. The second part is on video streaming. Here we implemented a setup for automatized measurements with the reference player Dev.js. And we performed measurements with 3 different adaptive bitrate algorithms, different videos, and different network settings. And out of these 7,000 video streaming sessions that we have collected, we studied the potential to improve video streaming QE. And all our implementations are made publicly available on GitHub to make our results reproducible. The videos have been encoded and segmented using FFmpeg and H.264. And we considered both variable bitrate encoding and constant bitrate encoding. When we did the variable segmentation, we proceeded as follows. We defined a certain maximum duration, which the variable segments are not allowed to exceed. Then we encoded one representation of a video, just without defining the segment duration. And this was enough for the encoder to be allowed to freely choose the segment duration between 0 seconds and the defined maximum duration. The keyframes are only forced if there has been no keyframe since the maximum duration interval. We lock the positions at which the video has been split and reuse these positions for encoding the video in other resolutions or bitrates to ensure that along all quality representations, the split positions are exactly the same. We encoded 4 different videos. And we chose 4 settings for the constant rate factor if we use VBR encoding, and 4 different settings for the target bitrate if we use constant bitrate encoding. We encoded each of these videos in 5 different resolutions, which were ranging between 240p and 2160p. And we also set four different settings for the maximum durations if we use the variable approach, which is shortened here as var. We compare the variable approach against the fixed approach in two different ways. The first one is called nearest average. In this case, the number of video segments are the same for the fixed approach and for the variable approach. And the second mode is equal max. In this case, the variable approach has the same maximum segment duration as the segment durations. Let us have a look on how different maximum duration settings, which are here denoted on the x-axis, impact the resulting segment durations, which are denoted on the y-axis. One thing that we can see is that in any case, the maximum segment duration is exploited. For example, here we have a maximum segment duration of 10 seconds, and we also observe segments of this duration. Furthermore, we can see that we have a slight increase of the average segment duration when the maximum segment duration increases, which is shown as the green triangles. And we can also observe that the median segment durations, denoted as the orange lines, are relatively stable over all configurations. Next, let's have a look on how many iframes we can economize if we allow segments ranging from 0 to 10 seconds. This is depicted in this plot. We see the four different videos, and the bar on the left-hand side denotes the iframes needed with the fixed approach, and the bar on the right-hand side denotes the number of iframes that are needed with the variable approach, and we already see that we can drastically reduce the number of iframes. Let's have a short look on the implications of the file size. We see that how much we can save is highly depending on the video. In the case of Big Bug Bunny, we can save 12% of the file size, while it is only 3.7% for the If We Enter video. This figure is summarizing the potential for saving bitrate over all CBR encoded videos in our test set. And we can observe that in 50% of the encoded sequences, we can save 7% of bitrate or even more. But we need to ensure that our visual quality is not suffering. For that reason, we evaluated the SSIM of the variable videos and the SSIM of the fixed videos, and we saw that the highest degradation in terms of SSIM that we could observe was 0.05, which is not noticeable to the user, and furthermore, in 60% of the cases, the degradation was less than 0.01. Next, we have a look on how variable segment durations impact the video streaming. For that, we have performed measurements in a testbed, which includes Dash.js, a network emulator, and a video server. We have tested all three adaptive bitrate algorithms that are included in Dash.js, a hybrid one, a throughput-based, and the Bola buffer-based heuristic. We have used real network traces that we scaled so to achieve an average rate limit of the 1 to 4 or 6 fold of each video's lowest bitrate. We have tested all the four source videos that we have and represented in 5 different quality levels, which were selected according to the bitrate ladder. And the segments were varying between 0 and 10 seconds. For evaluating the video streaming QE, we used the ITUT recommendation B1203, which is the first standardized quality of experience model for adaptive streaming. It considers all relevant influence factors for video streaming and also takes their temporal aspects into account. The ITUT model provides one overall quality score on MoScale and several diagnostic quality scores. We have used the per second audiovisual quality score, the stalling quality, and O46, which is the overall quality score, combining both the audiovisual and the stalling quality score. The table summarizes our results for the three different AVRs that we tested and for the different QE scores that we have evaluated. The numbers denote the median improvement along with the confidence intervals. And what we can see is that for any AVR, we are capable to improve the QE, and we have the highest potential of improving the QE if we use the hybrid AVR, because here we see for the overall quality score O46 that the improvements, the median improvements, are the highest. The QE score obtained with the variable approach minus the QE score with the fixed approach. This means if we are in this region, we worsen the QE. If we are in this right region, then the QE could be improved with the variable approach. And what we can see first is this green line denotes the audiovisual quality. This can be improved in 75% of all the evaluated streaming sessions. If we have a look on O23, which is the red line, this one denotes the stalling quality. And this shows that stallings could be reduced in 56% of all the measurement runs. The overall QE is denoted as the blue line, and this metric can be improved in 57% of all our test runs. We found that the potential of the variable approach to improve the QE is highly depending on the network capacity. For that reason, we will now have a detailed look on two cases, whereby the first one is where we set the rate limit as the one-fold of the lowest quality bit rate. In this case, the impact of the ABR is negligible. There is hardly a chance that we can switch to a higher quality than the lowest one. What we saw in this scenario was that the overall QE, denoted here as the blue line, can be improved in 64% of the cases. And one more thing I would like to mention is that our improvements are of a greater extent than the impairments. For example, while the stalling QE is decreased by maximum 0.5, the maximum improvement that we can have is almost 1.5. Let us now evaluate how the approach performs if we have a scenario with higher capacity limit. We set in this case the rate limit as the sixth-fold of the lowest video quality bitrate, meaning that now we are able to also switch to a medium and high quality. And as a result, the QE is now highly influenced by the decisions of the bitrate algorithm. What we can observe from this plot here is that the overall QE score is decreased in 55% of our streaming sessions. This means in the majority of the cases, the variable approach impaired the QE. The reason can be seen from the red line, because the variable approach increased the number of stallings that occurred. We concluded from this that the adaptation heuristic is not straightforwardly capable to deal with variable segment durations. Please note that not only the segment duration now has a higher variability, but also the segment sizes. And in this case, we see that the quality was adapted a bit too aggressive, leading to higher quality, but to more video stallings. And hence, in those scenarios where we have a higher capacity limit, we have more cases where the QE is degraded. This issue, however, can probably be eliminated with a dedicated heuristic that is tuned to deal with segments of variable durations. And this already brings me to the conclusion of this talk. We have evaluated the impact of variable segment durations for adaptive streaming on the one hand from the video encoding perspective, where we saw that we are capable to reduce the video bitrate while we still maintain a good quality. In terms of video streaming, we saw that we have a high potential of improving the QE, especially in low capacity scenarios. The study we have conducted has certain limitations, which I would shortly like to mention here. We had 4 source videos, which is quite a small set. However, this set has been extensively evaluated. Another thing is that our conclusions that we can draw are limited to the H.264 codec. However, that we can save iframes is independent from the used codec. So we also see a high potential for other codecs like H.265 or VP9. Lastly, I would like to mention that the capacities we have evaluated for the video streaming were relatively small. But nevertheless, we had scenarios where we could go for a medium or high quality, making the results generalizable. We plan to extend our set of videos by more codecs and more source videos. Furthermore, we plan to design a segment duration-aware heuristic
which is capable to better exploit the benefits of the variable approach also in high bandwidth scenarios. And with this, I would like to conclude, and I'm happy to receive and answer your questions in the Q&A session.